Have you ever struggled with setting up the perfect system for your work and life? In this guide, I'll share a TickTick system designed to manage plans and tasks. If you only need to manage simple to-dos, this system might be too complex. But for those who love managing everything, it will offer some inspiration. Now let's dive into today's video. In this system, everything is divided into two parts: plans and tasks. Plans are things you actively want to do to improve yourself, like losing weight, starting a side hustle, or learning a new skill. Tasks are the things you must do in your various roles, such as an employee, spouse, or parent. Things like work, chores, or appointments. Plans are often important but not urgent, and they yield results in the future. That's why I use the 12-week plan to manage these. It helps me set goals more effectively and track progress. This part corresponds to the Goals and Plans folder, which includes my vision and 12-week plan lists. Tasks, on the other hand, are often urgent and need to be done without much planning. That's why I use the classic GTD method to collect and organize tasks. GTD is perfect for managing a mountain of to-dos, and if your daily tasks are overwhelming, you'll love it. In my system, the GTD part includes actions, waiting, someday lists, and project folders. I'm sure many of you are already familiar with the GTD method, so feel free to skip this section if you don't need an introduction. But if you're still interested, I'll briefly explain how GTD works in my system. First, you need to dump everything you need to do into the inbox. Things like doing laundry every weekend, getting a haircut every month, paying credit card bill on the 5th, attending a meeting at 3 p.m. tomorrow, buying dog food, or planning a trip to Tokyo. This ensures your brain is clear. Then, at a fixed time, organize the inbox by moving tasks that need to be done soon or have clear deadlines to the actions list. Tasks that are delegated or waiting for someone else's feedback to the waiting list, and tasks without a clear execution date to the someday list. For tasks that are multi-step and complex, like renovate bathroom, I upgrade them into lists and manage them in project folders. Next, you need to organize the tasks in your GTD system, including but not limited to breaking down complex tasks into more actionable steps, using subtasks, and setting dates and times for tasks that have been scheduled. Finally, follow the due dates of each task, receive reminders, and handle tasks one by one in an orderly manner. To better categorize these tasks, I've added tags like work, personal, family, pets, and kids. When adding a task, you can simply type pound sign to quickly tag it, making it easier to identify task categories when browsing. These tags also help with using filters more effectively. For example, when I'm at work, I only need to view today's work tasks and avoid distractions from tasks in other categories. I've adopted the Eat That Frog method by creating a filter called Three Frogs, setting the date to today, the tag to work, and the priority to high. This helps me focus on today's key tasks. If there are more than three tasks, I proactively postpone the less urgent ones. Why three frogs? Frogs represent those difficult, easily procrastinated, yet important tasks that need to be prioritized in a day. If you could only complete three things today, what would they be? This is the question I ask myself every morning. In the past, I would list a bunch of to-dos, only to end the day without completing the truly important tasks. Later, I realized that focusing on just three key tasks a day is actually more efficient than listing 10. Of course, if your job requires you to handle far more than three important tasks a day, you can adjust flexibly. Just filter tasks with today's date and the work tag without limiting the priority. Once I've set up the filter, during work hours, I simply click on the TickTick icon in the Mac menu bar and switch to the Three Frogs filter to quickly see what key tasks are left for the day. This is how I manage my daily tasks, relying mainly on the GTD method for collecting and organizing tasks, and using tags and filters to focus on different categories in various scenarios. Now that we've covered the daily task management part of my system, let's move on to the plans section. Beyond the obligations and responsibilities of the roles I play in life, I also want to pursue my own goals. I've adopted the 12-week year system, using 12-week cycles to pursue goals outside my daily responsibilities. I must admit, I'm not someone with strong execution skills, and annual plans feel too long for me. They're full of variables, and all sorts of things can disrupt my plans. A year also gives me plenty of time to procrastinate. So instead of annual plans, I've started using 12-week plans. Before that, I take time to think about my goals. I write them down in the vision list, because I believe that only written goals are easier to remember and focus on. And if you're not sure how to write your goals, try asking yourself questions like, what's most important to me? Personally, professionally, physically, emotionally, and financially. How much money do I need to maintain a good standard of living? Where do I want to live? Where do I want to go? Through a series of questions, you'll find your answers. For example, I want to be healthy and maintain a low body fat percentage. I want to transition from a startup to a large corporation and get promoted to manager within 3 years. And besides my main job, I want to start a side hustle as a content creator. After writing them down, ask yourself, what can I do next to achieve these life goals? What small goals should I achieve in 12 weeks? Create a new list, like I did, and name it 12-week plan. Next, rename your sections to reflect the small goals you want to achieve in the first 12 weeks of your life goals. For example, to become a qualified content creator, my first 12-week goal is to reach 2,000 followers on my personal channel. To maintain a healthy body fat percentage, my first 12-week goal is to lose 5 kilograms. And to successfully transition and get promoted, my first 12-week goal is to obtain a professional certification. I recommend having no more than 3 small goals to stay focused. Next, plan and fill in the main tasks for each week within the groups. For example, to reach 2,000 followers on my personal account. Week 1, choose the target niche and main content platforms. Week 2, create a content plan for the trial period, and so on. Use subtasks to break down each week's plan in more detail. For example, meet with successful content creators to discuss experiences. Search for relevant information online and watch tutorials. Once the detailed plan is set, simply execute it week by week. Most people's lives revolve around weeks. I plan by the week and also review my plans weekly. At the end of each week, don't forget to review your plan's progress. I like to review my 12-week plans and their completion within my life goals. First, I write down what the first 12-week goal is. Format it as H1, and then the first week's goal, formatted as H2. Next, I use links to record what has been completed and what hasn't. The completed records are my victory log, reminding me of my achievements and how meaningful my persistence is. The incomplete records are my failure log, where I write down why it didn't succeed and how to make it succeed next time. After the review, the next step is to adjust the plan for the new week, keeping it up to date and ensuring weekly updates, continuous reflection, and improvement. This is my system and how it operates. TickTick isn't just about tasks. I also use the calendar and habit tracker to support my work. Everything I do daily is recorded in TickTick, and the monthly view gives me a clear overview of what I've done each month. When planning, the calendar helps me see how much free time I have. That's all for today's video. I don't expect you to follow my approach exactly, as everyone's habits and lifestyles are different. You need to adapt it to your own situation. You don't have to use it, but I hope you find inspiration here. I hope you discover the best way to use TickTick to perfectly fit your work and life. Don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you in the next video.